Yes, dear viewers, I welcome you once again to Standard High School Zana Virtual Classes. Today's discussion will be about trigonometry. As usual, my name is Ayjuka Oscar, a teacher of mathematics and physics. And today, I'm going to discuss pure mathematics, that is mathematics for senior 5 and senior 6. So with trigonometry, we're going to start with trigonometric ratios of acute angles under the trigonometry key ratios of acute angles. We can find the trigonometric ratios of the acute angles by using a right angled triangle. This is the right triangle whose sides are, this is A, this is B, and this hypotenuse is the H. And the acute angle in this case is A, and its complement will be 90 minus A. And definitely that means that the sine of angle A will be equal to, we obtain the trigonometric ratios from the acronym SOHO KATOA, meaning that the sine is the opposite over the hypotenuse from year 3, year 3 material. So the sine of angle A is given by the opposite, the side opposite to the angle A, it is A divided by the hypotenuse, which is the H. B is the is adjacent to angle A. This is where angle A sits, so this is the adjacent. And angle A, this is the opposite, and this is the hypotenuse. So we realize that sine of A is A over H. The cosine of A is, it is, according to this acronym, the adjacent over the hypotenuse, and that means it is B out of the hypotenuse, which is H. And then the tangent, the tan of A, is the opposite over the adjacent, and at angle A, the opposite is small a divided by the adjacent, which is small b. And those are the trigonometrical ratios of an acute angle A. Now, what about the trigonometrical ratio of this, of the complement of angle A? That is the 90 minus A. In this case, it is equivalent to, now 2 90 minus A, which is the complement, this side is opposite. This is its opposite, and it sits along this. So this is its adjacent, and this is the hypotenuse, the longest side. So the sine of 90 minus A in this case is the opposite, which is B, out of the hypotenuse, which is H. So if we look around these formulas, you realize that the cosine of A is equivalent to the sine of 90 minus A. So the cosine, we can now conclude that the cosine of A is the same as the sine of 90 minus a. In this case, the cosine of a is the same as the sine of its complement, a sine of its complement. We shall still find out that it is the same. This one is equivalent to this under compound angle formulas. Under compound angle formulas. So, you will also definitely find out that sine of A, we also definitely find out that sine of A is the same as the cosine of the complement of A. And definitely see that the cosine of 90 minus A, which is the complement, is equivalent to the adjacent, which is A, out of the hypotenuse, which is the sine of A. So that is to do with the trigonometrical ratios of the acute angles. And now we can now do find the trigonometrical ratios for particular angles, the ones that we call the special angles. And these may include 30, the 60, 45, maybe 90. So we're going to now look for the trigonometrical ratio of special angles, the particular angles. If we are to find the trigonometrical ratios of 30 degrees and 60 degrees, we consider an equilateral triangle, of side 2 units. 2 units means this one is equivalent to that. And once it is equilateral, then the interior angle is 60 throughout is the interior angle. And now if you bisect this, you definitely get 30 here, 30. And by bisecting that, means this will be the perpendicular bisector. And so upon extracting out the right angled triangle, here we see it is 60 degrees, this is 30. And if we bisect this, it being the perpendicular bisector, it means that from here to here, it is a half of 2, which is 1, and this is 2. So we can now find the height of this triangle, and we find the height of that triangle from the Pythagorean theorem. Pythagoras theorem, where, so if this is ABC, AB squared plus BC squared is the same as AC squared, So upon substituting in this, you realize that we have 1 squared plus BC, it is 8 squared, is equivalent to AC, which is 2 squared. So if we try to simplify this, we have 1 plus 8 squared is 2 squared, which is 4. You obtain your H as 4 minus 1, which is 3, and the H is the square root of 3. So we have now, can now redraw it. This is root 3, this is 60 degrees, this is 30, this is 2, this is 1. So from there we can now write the trigonometric ratios that the sine of 60 degrees, as we saw, that the sine of an acute angle is the same as the cosine of its complement. The complement to the 60 degrees is 30 degrees. And this is definitely equal to the sine of 60 degrees is the opposite, which is root 3 divided by the hypotenuse, which is 2. And then, if you are interested in finding the cosine of 60 degrees, this would be the same as the sine of 30 degrees, which is its complement. And this is given by the cosine to 60 degrees. This is its adjacent divided by the hypotenuse is a half. And if you are interested in the tangent of 30, this one is ideally equivalent to 1 out of tan of 60 degrees. And this is equal to tan of this, it is tan, it is the opposite over the adjacent, so it is 1 out of root 3. And the tan of 60, it is definitely root what? Root 3. Yes, so that is to do with the trigonometry of special angles. Maybe I can some illustrate a question. And before we look at an example, we can now look for the trigonometric ratio for 45, for an angle which is 45. If this is 45, then its complement is also 45. This is, we consider a right angle triangle which is isosceles. Means that the two sides are equal, 1, 1. And by Pythagoras theorem, if this is A squared is equivalent to 1 squared plus 1 squared, it gives you A squared as 2. And you obtain the value of A by taking the square root both sides, is given by root 2. So this, we have something like this. This is root 2, 1, 1, 45 degrees, and its complement is 45 degrees. That means that the sine of 45 degrees is the same as its cosine. It's the same as its cosine. So we can now write and say that the sine of 45 degrees, which is the same as its cosine, as we saw, is equivalent to the sine of 45, which is the opposite, divided by the hypotenuse, which is 1 out of root 2. And the tan of 45 degrees, which is equal to the opposite over the adjacent, that is 1 over 1, which is ideally 1. Which is ideally 1. And so now that we have obtained the values of these trigonometrical ratios of the angles 30 degrees, 60, and 45, we can have an example. And given that sine of A is 3 over 4, can use 3 over 5, and A ranges between 0 and 90 degrees, find the Roman 1, the cosine of A, Roman 2, the cosine squared plus the sine squared A, and then Roman 3, you find the tangent of A. The tangent of A. So solution, given the range for the values of A is acute. So if it is acute, then that means that we can find the trigonometric ratios of this acute angle A by using a right angled triangle. So by using a right angled triangle, we are given that the sine of A is 3 over 5. That means that if our angle A is there, then its opposite is 3 and the hypotenuse is 5. But we don't know the adjacent. So we can now find the adjacent. And that means that the adjacent, we obtain it by Pythagoras theorem, and it is equal to 5 squared. You obtain the adjacent is 5 squared minus 3 squared. The adjacent thus becomes the root of 25 minus 9, which is 4.